I ask her to say a few words of greeting, and greeting for you. You are coming here in such manner that is to study the principle of Buddhist Dhamma and training meditation to have a new life, or at least a new way of life. All of you coming here have to prepare yourself to be a scientist. If everyone had a farmer, gardener, businessman, or any kind of position, coming here to study Buddhism has to become a scientist. Everyone must be a scientist to study Dhamma, because Dhamma is a science. You have to prepare your mind as you prepare instruments in a scientific room to use it to prepare your mind by meditation to obtain mindfulness, attentiveness, wisdom and concentration, to use as an instrument in studying Dhamma. Dhamma is a law of nature, natural law of nature, ultimate truth of nature. It is not established by the Buddha or someone. The Buddha is a founder, the truth. Find it, the truth, and have it to proclaim to us. The truth is the truth. Not commandment of human being. And now you have to be a scientist, having the problem, the suffering, the satisfactoriness, every kind of problem as an object of experiment. Study it, know it, experience it, realizing it, and then you know the Dhamma. What is suffering? I prefer to use the Pali term dukkha. Suffering or dissatisfactoriness or problem or any kind have not a complete meaning of the term dukkha. Dukkha. Now what is dukkha? You have to study inside yourself, not from outside. When the dukkha existing or happening or being in the mind, look at it until to know it. If you know it, in reality, you will see the cause of it, condition of it, at the same time. And the cause of it is at it. The cause of suffering is at the suffering itself. When you know the cause, you can know the extinction of the problem by eliminating the cause. You can find the cause, and then you can find the destruction, extinction of the cause. And then you can see the way to raise the extinction of the cause, you will know what it is, from what it is, for what it is, and by what it is obtained. By this way, you can find the cause, the extinction of it, the way to, the way for the extinction of it. You will see, you will know, you will experience, realizing the Dhamma, the natural truth of Dhamma, by being a scientist in such a way. Now you prepare to be a scientist. We call it new life. That is the result of the practice, the Dhamma, the life that is beyond all problem, the life that is beyond on in, beyond influence of positive and negative. You have to know that. Positive and negative life is not a peaceful life. It has to be beyond the positive and negative. It will be free, it will be calm, it will be emancipated from all problems. And by this way, we are a spiritual scientist know the reality, the ultimate truth of nature concerning to suffering or problem of life. The result of a practice Dhamma in accordance with the law of nature, we can obtain nibbana. Nibbana literally meaning is the quenching of the heat or of the thirst. The third is heat, quenching of the heat, the coolness of the mind, nibbana. Nibbana is a supreme truth, supreme benefit, a supreme happiness, supreme wisdom, a supreme freedom of the life. And then we can call a supreme life, that is a new life with nibbana in itself. When the word heat of kilesa quench down, that is nibbana, the meaning of nibbana, example of nibbana. Even a little bit, we can extend it more and more, bigger and bigger, until the full scale of it is acquired. You want to have a new life, a life beyond influence of suffering, that is the life which is enslaved by the pair of opposite positivism and negativism. You will try your best in practicing meditation to obtain mindfulness first, and then wisdom from the training. The mindfulness at Pum Riang, taking wisdom come in time, just in time of the event. The wisdom beyond the mindfulness bring wisdom. Wisdom became attentiveness on the time, having concentration and power to solve the problem in the time. Then we can command the event, the process of kilesa. And then we are free from influence of kilesa. That is the suffering itself. You come here to study Buddhist Dhamma, to practice Buddhist meditation. I'm glad to see you coming here in such a manner, seeking for a new life. I'm glad to see you. Wish you on your success. All of your success. Then you can have a new life. Have a spiritual birth. Not physical birth, but a spiritual birth, the birth of the mind. The situation of the mind change to another form, with efficiency to command the mind. We cannot command outside thing, environment, outside thing, but we can command the mind inside. Not to accept anything in wrong way, to cause a problem, to cause dukkha. It is an important thing to know. We cannot command all outer things not to come, not to contact us. But we can command the mind not to accept it in the wrong way, to raise a problem and suffering. My mean of training the mind in the way of Buddhist meditation, we can do this. Then we can command all things that come into contact with us. That is the result of practice Dhamma, of coming here, of coming Suan Mokkh to study and to practice training the mind. You come here, such man, I'm very glad to see you. It is my greeting. Thank you to Bhikkhu, listener, and to be a good obedient to the regular rule of living here, of practicing the Dhamma meditation. And then you can have a succeed in your want. I am greeting you as a few words. Thank you, thank you. Here my greeting.